falls asleep.
It goes on and off. I woke up a few times. I don't have the warmest sleeping bags.
So we wake up to a little surprise.
We're gonna go see geyser erupts like every 10 minutes. And then we're gonna go see waterfalls, like this big ass waterfall. I guess one in Iceland. Pretty good stuff to start the day.
That's geyser, and then there'll be another one called striker or something. We just wait for it to erupt, and every 10 minutes apparently, 10 to 12 minutes.
Start throwing rocks at it. Erupt.
Waiting for that perfect shot.
To see more, insert more coins.
Yeah, exactly. Let's go, striker. Or is it stroker?
Ooh, yeah.
That was cooler.
Unannounced, too. Next was Gullfoss, the largest waterfall in Europe.
Ooh, pretty wild.
Getting a little wet.
After 9, we've probably already taken like 50 to like 70 photos.
Alright, what you're gonna see are the many layers of Stefan.
You start off with the standard thermal long sleeve. Over top, you get the standard issue black t-shirt. Then on next, you got this lovely black sweater. Hoodie. And that turns a cold Stefan into a warm Stefan.
And a warm Stefan is a happy Stefan.
Exactly.
Warm Stefan did not last very long.
A little bit cold. Wish I had a toque. Maybe some gloves.
Well, we're in Iceland now. Not that we weren't yesterday, but at least we can see it today. Got some waterfalls going on. I bet that water's pretty damn cold too. Because right now I'm feeling pretty damn cold.
We would have to find other ways to keep warm.
These high.
Search is complete. We have found her. I killed the last way out of this. Swayed by deceitful kiss. Driving past Reichholt, we ran into some wildlife.
Yeah. after a cold morning, nice cup of coffee.
I'm like a warm coffee to warm you up.
Yeah.
Feeling all good inside again. My hands are actually tingling.
Yeah, back to normal temperatures.
Yeah.
After warming up, we kept driving towards the east.
If you're a cowboy, I would trail you. If you're a piece of wood, I'd nail you to the floor. If you're a sailboat,
a few hours down the road was yet another waterfall, Seljalandsfoss.
Everything ahead of us we left, everything behind. But nothing that we needed at least, not at this time. And now the feeling that I'm feeling well, it's feeling like my life is finally mine. And with nothing to go back to, we just continue to drive.
We reached the most southern point of Iceland, Vik, where we took a break from driving and chilled on the black sand.
So without you I was broken, but I'd rather be broke down with you by my side.
Ready to check out some beaches, Iceland style?
Next time I bring my wetsuit and my board,
I'm
going surfing.
I didn't know what I was looking for, so I didn't know what I'd find. I didn't know what I was missing, I guess you've been just a little too kind. And if I find just what I need, put a little piece in mind.
It seems like every like 5 minutes we have to pull over for 2 minutes for pictures.
I know.
We continued up the southeast coast and stopped at Jokisaarland, where the giant glacier met the ocean.
So we were told there were some icebergs in Iceland. Couldn't find them on the ocean on the right, so we turned to the left and boom!
Oh, yeah.
Pretty luminous.
Because of severe winds and poor driving conditions, we were forced to pull over at Stafafo. This ended a very busy day for day two.